In this video, my papa will explain you what is the difference between union and union all. I know this is a tough question in the interview, but my papa knows all.
So that was my kid Sanjana. So as she has said that in this video, we're going to talk about what is the difference between union and union all. Now you can see on your screen, you know, there are two tables here. One is called as the ancillary table and the other one is called as the main product table. So you can see that the ancillary table has a product name and amount, while the main product also has a product name and amount. So I'll just say here, select star from ancillary, go and select star from main product. Okay. And let me say execute. Now you can see that, you know, when I fire both these select statements, it is creating two outputs here. The top output actually displaying the results of the ancillary table, and the bottom output actually displaying the results of the main product table. Now what I would like to do is that I would like to go and combine both these records in one record set. In other words, I don't want to display them in this way in different windows, but I would like to display them in a one selected row, or in a one record set. So how do we do that? And that's done by using union. So what you can do here is that you can go and say union, and if you say select, so now you can see that both the records of the ancillary table as well as the main product table has been combined into one record set. So you can see that, you know, from the ancillary table we have jam and egg, you can see that, and from the main product table we have white bread and brown bread. So all the records are now combined into one record set. So the basic use of union is to go and combine, you know, two select statements and basically, you know, display them as one record set. Definitely, you know, when you go and write select statements, you know, the number of columns as well as the data types of both the select statements should match.
But papa, there are two eggs. Where is the other egg?
Kids are smarter nowadays, and Sanjana has got me right. What she mean to say is that your ancillary table has an egg record, your main product table also has an egg record. So in other words, this 3 plus 2 should display 5, right? But it's only displaying 4 records here. So what happened to the other egg record? Now, when we use union, right, it does not display duplicate values. In other words, here the value of egg is egg 20. And in the main product, the value of egg is egg 20 again. So that's why what it has done is it has said that this is a duplicate value and it just displayed one value. Now, if you want to go and display also the duplicate values, you have to say union all so that my kid gets all the eggs. So if I say execute now, there you go. You can see that we have one egg record here and the other egg record here. And so total, we can see that we have 5 records. So the difference between union all and union is that union all displays duplicate values, while union does not display duplicate values. In case it finds a duplicate value, it will just take the distinct out of it. Okay. So I hope that next time when you go to the SQL Server interview, and if somebody asks you what the difference between union and union all, I'm sure that now you are set right, because even my kid understood what is the difference between union and union all, and I'm sure that you should also understand well. Thank you so much.